Yes, bitch. Yes, bitch. Oh my gosh. Hi guys, it's me, Jack Vidgen. I am out of the jungle and I'm here. It's my first morning out and I'm about to have an amazing breakfast. Right here I have a piece of sourdough with some poached eggs, some halloumi, a whole avocado. I'm not too sure what to do with this. It's nice just even knowing that you've got avocado as an option. I have a coffee, gorgeous, gorgeous coffee. Oh. And I have a little bellini. Cheers. So each morning in camp, we would get oatmeal for breakfast. So we'd have a very small amount of oats and we'd put it in a pot, fill it up with some water, let it boil, and that was our breakfast. Not super flavorsome. Honestly, it wasn't too bad because I love oatmeal. I was just missing the honey and the cinnamon and the berries and the yogurt to go with it.
Oh, yes, bitch.
Yeah. Yes, bitch is just something that you just say with your friends. It's just when you're encouraging each other, you're just like, yes, bitch, come on, bitch. It could have gone either way in camp. But of all people, Dipper was the one that wanted to learn the lingo. And from that moment, he was just going around camp going, yes, bitch, yes, bitch. And it was the best thing ever.
Yes, bitch.
Yes, bitch. Is that the way you do it?
My friendship with Dipper was really special. He was probably the last person I thought I was going to connect with. Like, getting to connect with an older straight guy that wants to know about your struggles and struggles of sexuality and just wanting to listen and find out about your life and your journey is new to me. And that was really cool to experience and really special, because when you haven't had that, you can question all the straight men in your life, because you think, okay, do they put you in this box over here because they think you're weird? When you've had those experiences, that's just what your mind does. And it was really special to kind of have that friendship with Dipper, someone who seems the polar opposite of me, but Grant said it perfectly, that Dipper is the gayest straight guy ever. Cheers to that. In camp, I feel like I got the closest to Pauline and Jess, ironically, because that was the two people that I entered the jungle with. And I think from the get-go, we just had this bond formed from jumping out of a helicopter together. Also, even when we were divided into teams, and all three of us were in different teams, we still kind of kept that bond, and our relationship, I think, that between the three of us really grew. I think the three of us were kind of like the three musketeers, and we really stuck together, and when we were feeling down, we lifted each other up, and it was really, really beautiful. There wasn't really anyone in camp that I didn't get along with. There was a few moments where I had a few conversations with people, where a few incidents happened, and I'm glad I actually approached them and talked to them about it, because we were able to put it behind us. And because no one likes tension, especially when you're in a camp. There's 12 of you and it's not a huge space, so being stuck there with people, you don't want to have issues. And anyway, with those people that I had those conversations with, we ended up forming great relationships. I think the scariest moment I had on the show, initially it would have been diving out of the helicopter. It was the biggest shock to the system, until I did the freezing cold water trial, where I had to get into 8-degree water and dive down within 9 minutes and pump as hard as you can while you're underwater to fill up a tank and get stars. I think because I went into that trial just going, oh, it's just a bit of cold water, why is everyone freaking out? I know why they freaked out now, because it was freaking tough and I've never experienced anything like that. And I think afterwards was probably one of the scariest moments I've had in my life, because your body's convulsing so much, you can't breathe in to take air in. It's so insane. And I knew there was a whole team of medics and we were fully covered, but you can't help but feel like you're gonna die, basically. I was crying my eyes out during the trial, and Grant just looked like he was dead. Pettiflor was screaming like she was having an exorcism. So it was just all seeming a bit scary at the time. My biggest takeaway from the entire experience, I think, would just be that I really realized I'm capable of more than I thought I was. I did not think going into it that I would even be able to do all the trials, let alone win some of them. Like, that to me was just the craziest thing. And that gave me so much confidence in myself. And also just the time you've got to reflect on your life, I will treasure that forever, because that was one of the most special things to me. My final message to my campmates is just that I love you all. You guys have changed my life. I went into this experience hoping that I'd meet some amazing people and hoping that I'd learn more about myself. And I think that really happened because of the people I was in camp with. And it's been one of the most amazing experiences of my life. And I'm just really excited to see everyone on the way out.